We would like to derive the area of the circle using the single integral, and the area formula is pi r squared. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to center this circle at the origin, and these points we're going to label r0 and negative r0. Okay? So as you know, the area formula, if you're speaking of integration, will be the area under a curve from A to B, and if we're going to take the derivative with respect to x value, suppose that we want to find the area of this upper half. Let's make it something like this. So suppose we want to find the area of this. We would be finding the area under this curve, right? Okay, and we should express the curve as the function of x, because we're going to take the derivative, antiderivative with respect to x, right? It's going to be the dx integral. So, since the circle is centered at the origin, the equation of the circle is x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared, right? Because the radius is r, okay? And as you should know, y is equal to the function of x. So that means we should rewrite the y in terms of x. Okay, so rewriting the y, we will get y squared is equal to r squared minus x squared. And since we're talking about the upper portion of the circle here, we're only going to discuss the positive y values, right? We're only thinking of the positive y values. So for this reason, when you take the square root on both sides, you're going to have the positive square root r squared minus x squared. Okay, there you go. So that's your function of x. So we successfully found the function of x. So the area is going to be from a to b. Now a and b are the limits of integration, lower and upper limits, right? The lower limit is negative r, right? And the upper limit is r. Okay, and the function of x, as we just derived, is square root r squared minus x squared dx integral. Perfect. Now you might be stuck. You might be thinking, well, how do I take the integral? I can't use the u substitution. Well, you can use the trigonometric substitution, right? Recall that we can, this form, r squared minus x squared, r is the constant in this case. This calls for the x being the r sine theta, and the dx is going to be r cosine theta d theta, right? Because you're differentiating both sides implicitly. So now you can rewrite this area, negative r to r, r squared minus, now the x is what? R sine theta. So squaring it, r squared sine squared theta, right? And dx is what? R cosine theta d theta. R cosine theta d theta. There you go. Right? So, but the only problem is here that you need to change your variables, your limits of integration, because right now the negative r to r is in terms of x, right? It relates to the x variable. These are the x variable limits, but we need the theta variable limits now, right? So in order to do that, notice that we can write this in terms of theta. In other words, solve this equation for theta. So sine theta is going to be what? Is going to be x over r, right? And solving for theta, you need to take the arc sine. So it means the theta is arc sine of x over r. There you go. Great. So now you can plug these limits, negative r and r, into this and find the limits for the theta variable and not the x variable, right? So plugging in negative r here, we're gonna get arc sine of negative 1. Arc sine of negative 1 is negative pi over 2, right? So let me erase this and write negative pi over 2. And arc sine Now, when you substitute the r here, you're going to get arc sine of 1, right? Arc sine of 1 is precisely pi over 2. So let's erase this and write pi over 2. Perfect. So now it's going to be so much easier. Now, the only thing, you're trying to find the area of the entire circle, not just the blue part. But notice that there's symmetry. There's symmetry, right? So this half is exactly the same value in its area as the lower half. So for this reason, all we can do is just multiply this pretty integral by 2, right? And then we'll have the precise area of the circle formula. So we're going to set it to twice the integral, okay? So then we're going to have twice from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. And let's simplify what we have. Notice that r squared minus r squared sine squared theta can be factored like this. 1 minus sine squared theta, right? Then r cosine theta d theta. Now, we'll keep going. So let's see, r squared can be taken out now. Square root of r squared is r. Multiplied with the outside r will become r squared, right? And 1 minus sine squared theta is cosine squared theta, right? Using the identity. Sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. So 1 minus sine squared theta, if you subtract sine squared, is cosine squared theta. Square root of cosine squared, well, I might just write it so that you're not carried away with too many steps before I write them. So I will have this, in other words, okay? So I will have cosine squared theta inside the square root. Okay, keep going. So now r is constant, right? The radius is constant because we're talking about one circle. So we can take out the r outside, the r squared precisely outside. And let's see, square root of cosine squared theta is cosine theta. Multiplied with the second cosine theta, bingo, cosine squared theta. Square root is out, very good, d theta. Okay, so that is becoming more manageable to solve, right? Notice that now we're going to use the identity. Cosine squared theta is equal to 1 half, 1 plus cosine 2 theta. Okay, so we're going to have 2r squared from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. 1 half, 1 plus cosine 2 theta d theta. Okay, so let's keep going. Notice that immediately you can see this. The 2's cancel out here, right? 2 divided by 2 is 1. So we essentially have this, r squared from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. 1 plus cosine 2 theta d theta. Okay, so the first term becomes theta as the antiderivative, right? R squared theta from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, right? And then we have r squared cosine 2 theta d theta, right? So what happens? So we subtract the lower limit of integration from the upper limit of integration into the theta. Right, so basically this is what's going to happen. Pi over 2 minus the lower limit, negative pi over 2. Right, so we replace this difference, in other words, of the upper and lower limits of integration, we replace the theta with the difference. Okay, that's what we did. Okay, now the second, it's not equal yet. The second integral. Oh, I should have added this, didn't I? I should have added this. I don't know why I subtracted. I should have added that. That's the second part of the integral. So plus, right? Okay, so that's the first part. The second term, we can use the u substitution, letting u being 2 theta. Du is equal to what? Du is equal to 2 d theta. There's no 2 there. Well, 2 will appear as the du, and since there was no 2 there originally, we will have to have a half outside to compensate for the 2 that popped up, right? So we're going to have plus 1 half r squared. Well, let's see, I will have to change the variables of integration one more time. Okay, so now it's going to be the u variable, so plugging in the negative pi over 2 into the theta, we will get negative pi, right? So negative pi, and the upper one becomes a pi, right? Plugging in here the theta, pi over 2, 2's cancel out, we just get a positive pi, right? So cosine u du, right? That's what we get, okay? So let's see, the first term is just what? 2 pi over 2, right? It's just adding pi over 2 and pi over 2 because negation makes it positive. 2 pi over 2 is a pi, right? So we just get pi r squared. So your intuition might lead you to believe that this second integral will probably become 0 because it looks like we should be arriving at the formula pi r squared of the circle, right? But let's check that. Let's make sure it does turn to 0. So notice that antiderivative of cosine is sine, right? So it's going to be 1 half r squared sine u, right? From negative pi to pi. Okay, so let's see, we get pi r squared plus 1 half r squared, and again we're gonna plug the pi and negative pi, we're gonna replace the u with the difference of the upper and lower limits, right? So sine of pi, should write that a little better, sine of pi minus sine of negative pi. So what do we get? We get pi r squared, the first term doesn't change, and then plus 1 half r squared. Now what is sine of pi? It's 0, right? What is sine of negative pi? 0 still, so 0 minus 0, right? And then what happens? 0 minus 0 becomes just 0, right? 0 multiplying the 1 half r squared stays the 0. So we just cross it out because it's irrelevant. And guess what? Our intuition was correct. The second term is indeed 0. So the first term remains, and that's exactly the area of the circle formula. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.